Hello children, now we are on the topic quantum numbers. It is a part of a structure of atom. So what are quantum numbers? It is a set of four numbers which helps us in identifying the exact location, position, energy, orientation, spin. Each and every finer detail of the electron can be obtained by using the term quantum numbers. So the quantum numbers are of four types. The first one is known as the principal quantum number. The principal quantum number helps us in telling about the energy level or the shell in which the electron is present. When we talk about the azimuthal quantum number, the azimuthal is the second quantum number. It tells us about the subshell. The third is magnetic quantum number, which tells us about the orientation in the orbital. But the fourth one is the spin quantum number that tells us about the clockwise or anti-clockwise orientation, the movement of the electron in the orbital. So we will be moving one by one in the detail of these quantum number, and then we will do some of the very important questions of NCERT related to the quantum numbers. So let's move on to the first quantum number, that is the principal quantum number. Principal quantum number is denoted by N, and it represents mainly the shell, the energy level, which we used to call the orbit previously. In case of Bohr, the energy of these orbitals can be orbits can be calculated by using the Bohr energy formula also. Since the most probable distance between the nucleus and the electron is described by it, a larger value of principal quantum number implies the greater distance between the nucleus and the electron. So if it is, the value is larger, there is a greater distance, but if the value is smaller, then it means there is a smaller distance between the electron and the electron and the nucleus. So principal quantum number, that is N, which is equal to the shell number, it is represented either by K element, the shell, which we used to call as K Lmn, or in terms of principal quantum number N, we used to call it as 1, 2, 3 and 4. The principal quantum number cannot have the value 0. So principal quantum number is related to the shell, the energy level. Now students, we are on the azimuthal or subsidiary quantum number. Azimuthal quantum number explains the fine structure of the line spectrum. It tells us about the number of the subshells present in the main shell. It tells us about the shape of the orbitals also. It is represented by small l, and its value is related to the principal quantum number by the relation 0 to n minus 1. So in case of s, when we are talking about the azimuthal quantum number S, then the azimuthal number is represented by L. But for S1, the value of L is taken as 0. For P, the value of L is taken as 1. For D, the subshells we are associated, L is taken as 2. The azimuthal quantum number for D is 2. And for F, the azimuthal quantum number is 3. Similarly, we can go on for G and also. So the azimuthal quantum number is having the symbol L. It is having the formula 0 to n minus 1. It helps in identifying the shape of the orbital also. Now the third quantum number is magnetic quantum number. When we are talking about the magnetic quantum number, it is represented by Mn. The magnetic quantum number distinguishes the orbitals when we are also identifying the direction related to the subshell also. It distinguishes the orbitals available with a subshell. And this is used to calculate the azimuthal component of the orientation of the orbital in space. So main thing related to it is orientation. It also helps in identifying the orientation of the orbital in the space. It is required to explain the splitting of the lines in the magnetic field. Splitting, it is required basically for these purpose, the splitting of lines in the magnetic field. Now the electrons in the subshell case, when we are talking about subshell, the sp, d and f, which are represented by azimuthal quantum number L0, 1, 2, 3, so the value of ml, the value of ml can change range from minus l to plus l including 0. So this time we can easily see that each of the quantum number is related to the previous one. When we are talking about n, it is the shell number. When we are talking about the azimuthal quantum number, it is related to n by 0 to n minus 1. When we are talking about the magnetic quantum number, it is related to the previous azimuthal by the relation minus L to plus L including zero. Now for the spin quantum number. The spin quantum number, the symbol is MS, M with a subscript of S. The spin quantum number is the fourth quantum number and it describes the orientation of the electron, whether it is moving in the clockwise and the anti-clockwise direction. The symbol that we use for the spin quantum number is MS, and it can have the value plus half or minus half, plus half or minus half for each of the value of ML. Now, it is either also represented as plus half or the upward arrow, and the minus half or the downward arrow. Now, we can see that the spin quantum number is also related to the previous one, that is the magnetic quantum number. So, revising the whole, all the four quantum numbers are related to each other. So, together they all helps in identifying the each and every detail of the electron in the shell. Now, there is a relationship between the various quantum numbers when we are talking about the orbital s, p, d, f, g. So, the azimuthal value for these, s is L is equal to 0, for p L is equal to 1, for d L is equal to 2, f L is equal to 3, and for g L is equal to 4. Now, the ML. The ML part is the magnetic quantum number. So, the magnetic quantum number is also related to the L by the relation minus L to plus L including 0. So, the 0 is included in between. For L is equal to 0, ML is equal to 0. For L is equal to 1, ML can have the value minus 1, 0 and plus 1. For L is equal to 2, the range is similar, minus 2 to plus 2, including all the numbers in between. And including zero also. Now, when we are talking about s, the number of values for the s orbital is only one. But for p, it is 3, minus 1, 0, plus 1, which are later on known as px, py, and pz. For d, it is 5. For f, it is 7. And for g, it is 9. Now, in case of each orbital, the maximum number of electrons that can be placed are 2. In the orbit, we used to say 2 and square, but in the orbital, it is only the 2 electrons which can reside together, but in the opposite direction. So, the electrons per subshell, for S it is 2, for P it is 6, for D it is 10, for F it is 14, and for G it is 18. So, along with this, now we will move to do the various simple numericals related to it, simple questions of these topics. Before doing this, let's have a look of values of magnetic quantum number. That is the value of ML for different orbitals associated. For example, if we are saying that P can have the three value minus 1, plus 1 and 0. So plus 1 is usually, according to the latest convention, the plus 1 is given for PX, minus 1 for PY and 0 for PZ. Similarly for the D, the latest convention for D, that is the number 2. We know that for the ML, the 2 is related as minus 2 to plus 2 including 0. So 0 is given for dz square, plus 1 for xz, minus 1 for yz, plus 2 for x square minus y square of d, and minus 2 for xy of d. So according to latest convention, the various parts of the orbitals for p, d are related by the various numbers also. Now, an electron in the 4f orbital. Let's do some questions. An electron in the 4f orbital is there. So what are the possible values for the quantum number n, l, m and s? When we are talking about 4f, so it is very clearly that n is equal to 4, the main shell number. Now we are only restricted to 4f. So the azimuthal quantum number is only related to f. Revising the term, S is equal to 0, P is equal to 1, D is equal to 2, and F is equal to 3. So the value of L becomes 3. But what about ML, the magnetic quantum number? The magnetic quantum number can have the value of L from minus 3 to plus 3, including 0. So minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, and plus 3. Now what about the spin? The spin quantum number can have the value plus half and minus half for each value of ML. For each value of ML. So each of the quantum number are side by side related to the previous one also. Now coming to the second question, using SPDF notation, describe the orbital with the following quantum numbers. We have to give the name of the orbital. So if n is equal to 2 and l is equal to 1, n 2 hai aur l 1, then l 1 is for the p orbital, so the name becomes 2p. L is equal to 4 and l is equal to 0, n is equal to 4. So 0 is for s, then it becomes the 4s. N is equal to 5 and l is equal to 3, 5. And when l is equal to 3, we are about the epsilon. Then n is equal to 3, l is equal to 2. Then 3 and l is equal to 2 is for the d subshell. We are writing here d. So these are usually the half marks question. The SPDF notation is used for representing the exact location here. Now coming to the third question. In n is equal to 5, how many electrons can have the magnetic quantum number value? Magnetic quantum number value of plus 1. Okay. So when we are n is equal to 5. N is equal to 5. So the L values can be 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The ML value. Now, in case of 0, it will remain 0. But for 1, it can be plus 1, minus 1 or 0. So plus 1 must be 1 time in case of this. Okay, plus 1, 0, minus 1. For 2, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. For 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. And for 4, it is minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, and plus 4. So, how many times the plus 1 is appearing, we have to find out. 1, 2, 3 and then the 4. So the total number of this value plus 1 is 4 times. Now it is appearing 4 times. So how many electrons? We know that 2 electrons can be placed in each of the orbital. So since plus 1 is appearing 4 times, so total number of electrons is equal to 8, because in each of the orbitals, the total number of electrons that can be placed are 2. So the total number of electrons in 4 times of the plus 1 is 8 electrons. Now, what is the lowest value of n that allows d orbital? So let us find out. When n is equal to 4, the total number of orbitals are s, p, d and f. So when n is equal to 5, the total numbers of orbitals are s, p, d, f and g. So what is the lowest value? That is n is equal to 5. We can give the answer directly also, because we know that the number of the subshell is directly equal to the number of the shell, the number of subshells. So if we are in the shell number 5, so the total number of the subshells associated will be s, p, d, f, g. Now for an electron in 3D orbital, give the possible values of n, l and it is ml. Okay, n, l and ml. So for 3D, n is equal to 3, the principal quantum number. We are talking about the azimuthal. The azimuthal is the d or d subshell now. So in case of d, the value is 2. Now the value of ml, the ml is related to the l. So it can have the value minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1 and plus 2. Now, how many electrons in an atom can have the following quantum numbers? We are in fourth shell and the total number of electrons will be 2n square, that is 2 into 4 square, which is equal to 32 electrons. So out of these 32 electrons, the 16 will be moving clockwise, that is with the plus half spin, and 16 will be moving anti-clockwise, that is with the minus half spin. So they are asking you about the number of the spin electrons with the plus half spin. So the answer is going to be 16. Okay, now when we are on n is equal to 3 and l is equal to 0, that is we are in the 3s. So when n 3 and l is equal to 0, that is we are in the 3s, the total number of electrons are 2, because s can accommodate, the each orbital can maximum accommodate the 2 electrons. So total number of electrons in this case is equal to 2 electrons. Now, these are few questions related to the quantum number. Now in the last one, let us have a very fast look how we can calculate the total number of electrons in each of the shell. So the first case, we are on shell number K. The principal quantum number is 1. The azimuthal quantum number is related to this one, it is 0. The magnetic quantum number is related to the L, minus L 0 and plus L, it is again going to be 0. But for the spin, we are always having the plus half and minus half. The total number of electrons, this quantum number is plus half and minus half. Total electrons present will be 2. And total number of electrons in the first shell, again going to be 2. So how we can represent it? We can represent it as, since it is the S1, the azimuthal quantum number, we can represent it as 1s2. Let us come to the other one, KL2. The azimuthal quantum number n can have the value 0 and 1 because the formula is 0 to n minus 1. The formula 0 to n minus 1. For magnetic quantum number, minus L to plus L, including 0. For spin, plus half, minus half, for each ml. Okay, so I have written the formulas also. So for 0, the magnetic quantum number is going to be 0. But for 1, it is minus 1, 0 and plus 1. For 0, it is again going to be plus half, minus half. For minus 1, plus half, minus half. For 0, plus half, minus half. And for 1 also, it is plus half and minus half. So 2 electrons are going to be in the S1 and 6 electrons are going to be in the P. So total number of 2 electrons in this part and total number of 6 electrons in the P azimuthal quantum number. So total electron becomes 2 plus 6, that is 8. And the configuration becomes 2s2 and 2p6. Now let's come to the third shell. This is the M, known as the number 3. So it can have the azimuthal quantum number 0, 1 and 2. So how we are going to represent is 0 as S, 1 as P and 2 as D. For 0, the value will remain 0. For P, it is minus 1, 0, plus 1. For D, it is going to be minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1 and plus 2, the 5 values. For 0, it will be plus half, minus half. Similarly, for minus 1, 0 and plus 1, it is plus half, minus half, plus half, minus half, plus half and minus half. So in case of the S, the total number of electrons are 2. In case of P, the total number of electrons are 6. And in case of D, there are 5 parts. The 5 magnetic, the quantum number which are associated are ML. For spin quantum number, it is MS. We can represent it as MS. Okay. So for minus 2, it is plus half, minus half. For minus 1 also, plus half, minus half. For 0, it is plus half, minus half. For 1, it is plus half, minus half. And for plus 2 also, it is plus half and minus half. So the total number of electron in the the D part, the 3D, becomes 10. So 2 plus 6 plus 10, the total number of electron becomes 18. How we can write it as 3s2, 3p6 and 3d10. Similarly, we can carry on for the other quantum numbers also, for 4 and 5 also. So it also proves the 2n square rule. 2n square rule, in the first one there are 2 electrons. In the second one, 2 into 2 square, that is the 8 electrons. And in the third one, 2 into 3 square, that is the 18 electron. So in this way, we can calculate the quantum number and can also identify the subshell and the orbitals with along with the spin of the electron, clockwise or anti-clockwise, in which it is present. So revise these questions, children, and go through the notes part. Now we will meet in the other lecture, doing the various rules for filling of the electronic configuration.